government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Yep. The Lord became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
He will be a joy and a delight to you, and many will rejoice because of his birth.
Okay, these verses all sound familiar to you. Some of them may be coming from the Old Testament, some coming from the New. Some coming before Jesus ever came, and the statements being made about him here, and yet some of them coming right before he came, and then even as was read by Neil, even after he'd come and gone. He became flesh. He became one of us. One of the things that amazes me so much is we don't like to become vulnerable, do we? It's uncomfortable to be put in a position where we feel vulnerable. And yet here is the Creator, the one who made everything, and he placed himself in a tiny body, completely vulnerable to this world. Not just to the elements of the world, not just to the various things that can happen to us as people, but vulnerable to mankind itself. I mean, the amazing things that says about our God, the amazing things that says about Jesus becoming flesh, he has no fear. We find ourselves at times being afraid of various things. He has no fear. He has no fear because he has complete confidence. And when we see Jesus, the confidence that he placed in the Father, first of all, to become flesh, because Jesus wasn't introduced on the scene as a baby. Jesus was introduced on the scene, and in the beginning, God created heaven and earth, as far as mankind is concerned. But yet that he was willing to place himself in this position. No fear, but complete.
I
everything started over, so you can start at the beginning. Thank you.
Flowing on me in the snow, a boy will read. so much that you did not reside in heaven and say, okay, humans, figure something out about me. For you came and lived for a while among us. You put on skin, you lived a life like we live, and you showed us how it's to be done right. Father, in the midst of having family together and opening presents and eating all that great food, may we keep in mind that really the point of Christmas is to remind us that certain things are really real, certain things really aren't. Certain things are worth doing, certain things really aren't. That love is ultimately the only thing that matters. Thank you for loving us and giving us a chance to love you back and to love each other. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Oh, well.
Or are you?
Yeah, I do work at a hospital.
Okay. Work at a website.